guys, so for this video, I'm going to be showing you some easy Megaminx PLLs that are not 3x3 Aux EPLLs or CPLLs, with the exception of two cases, which are two incredibly easy 5 cycles that I feel are worth showing. Alright, so here we have the two 5 cycles. As you can see, they both have headlights. And the only difference is, one, the edge needs to go to the right, and the other one, the edge needs to go to the left. So I'm going to show this one first. For this one, you're going to perform one of the edge algs that you learned for For Loc last layer, which I will assume you already know. And then you perform the T-perm. Really easy case. And then for this one, you're going to hold it so the headlights on your left and right, like this, and the until the edges in the back right there. Then you're going to perform the other edge alg for For Loc last layer, which is where the edge needs to go here. You're going to do U, then you do the T-perm, and you do another U. Both incredibly easy cases. I highly recommend you learn them because you're not really even learning another alg. It's just a combination of two algs. So yeah, definitely learn those. Alright, so for these next two cases, they both have little blocks that look similar to the T-perm block on 3x3. And then they both have a line in the back. One, it's on the left, and the other, it's on the right. Alright, so for the one where the line is on your left, you're going to hold it like this. And you're going to perform this algorithm. So for the one with the block on the right, you're going to hold it like this, and you're going to perform this algorithm. Alright, so for this next case, you have two lines. One is correctly lined up, and see this edge needs to go here, but even if we line up this one, this edge still needs to go here. So the way you're going to hold this case to solve it is you're going to line one up, and you're going to rotate. So you have two unsolved edges here. You want to make sure you're not holding it like this where one unsolved edge is. You want to hold it so you have two right here. And you're going to perform this algorithm. Really easy to recognize case, and the alg is pretty nice too. Alright, so for this next case, you have three 1x2 lines. And then you have it so this block needs to go here. And these two pieces are just kind of mismatched. So that's how you want to hold it, because you can hold it, say, like this, where you have a line here, but you don't want that. You want to hold it so these two are mismatched, and then this set of pieces go here. I personally think this case is easy to recognize, so yeah, here's the algorithm. Alright, so for this case, you have two blocks. How you want to hold it is, so you have one block lined up and the other one is on the right, because if you look, hold it like this, this block is on the left, we don't want that, we want it to be on the right. And you're going to perform this algorithm. So for these two cases, they each have a block in the back, and then they each have a line. One has a line on the left, and the other has a line on the right. Alright, so for the line on the right case, you're going to hold it like this. You're going to perform this algorithm. And then for this case, you're going to hold it like this. You're going to perform this algorithm. Alright, so for this case, it looks similar to the standard J-perm, as you can see, except if you look, for this one you have edge corner here, but for this one your edge and corner is here. So for this case, you're going to want to hold it like this, so you have a little line here. You don't want to hold it like this, because if you look, your little line's over here, we don't want that, we want to hold it then to hold it to our little line is right here. And they're going to perform this algorithm. Alright, so for these two cases, you have blocks or little lines all around, and two of them can line up at the same time. So the way you tell the difference is in between these two solved blocks, you have the pair, these two lines and the corners here, but for this one, the corner's here, like, and that one's part of the line. Also note for these two cases, if you look, so these two pieces need to go here, but if you were to do a U2 prime, then you can look and see that these two would need to go here, but we don't want that, we want it so they need to go here, so, yeah. Alright, so you're gonna hold it like this, and you're gonna perform this algorithm. Alright, so for this case, the two pieces need to go this way. If you get it where they need to go here, just gonna do a U2 prime and rotate, and then they need to go here. I'm gonna perform this algorithm. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you guys learned some easy PLLs, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.